Hey there, freaking morning. You're watching Proactive London, and joining us this morning from Diversified Energy is Rusty Hutson, the CEO of the company. Good to see you, Rusty.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing really well, thank you. So we're going to go through your results that have just been published. This is for 2021. Maybe just take us through the highlights initially, and then we'll dig into the detail.
Sure. Yeah, it was a year of records really for us. I mean, you know, we reported record EBITDA of $343 million, which was up substantially from the previous year. You know, we continue to hit $1 billion worth of revenue for the first time as a company, which was a first, which was great. You know, we continue to see very robust cash margins, more than 50%, which has been a consistent mantra for us. We've obviously closed a couple of ABS transactions to enhance liquidity as we ended the year. And so all in all, just a very good year for Diversified. And we closed on four pretty large transactions, which we've talked about previously.
Yeah, and we're going to talk about those a bit later on. But let's just pick up on what you were saying about the macro environment here, because there's been an improvement in the macros, the commodity price environment, we're all talking about it. What is your perspective on these trends kind of looking forward though?
Yeah, Katie, we're in for a long problem, I'm afraid. I think that the macro is going to continue to improve in terms of the oil and gas environment, which in this case is probably not the best for consumers and industry. You know, oil prices are continuing to, even as I sit here today, oil prices are continuing to go up. Natural gas has been robust for a while, but more importantly, as you look out the curve, you're seeing those prices not only continue to be stable, but they're increasing. That's a problem. I think we're going to continue. That tells me that the world sees the prices and they're saying, we don't think there's going to be enough supply. And so, and we're not here in the US, we're not seeing the big producers, the big exploration companies really put a bunch of rigs on and try to grow production. So it's all leading to a pretty bad place. And especially with the Russia oil out of the market, it's just not a good situation.
No, it's not. Well, let's maybe pick up on what you were saying just a second ago about those acquisitions as well. Let's talk about those in more detail, because 2021 was a very active year. We caught up a couple of times on these. You entered the new central region. That was a big deal for the firm. Can you maybe talk about these acquisitions in terms of your long-term strategy and how they've impacted the firm's performance kind of overall?
Yeah, well, you know, we did four transactions in 2021 in this region. Funny thing is that, you know, it represents about 40% of our production now. And so in less than a year, we've increased production. You know, it represents 40% of the overall company production, which sits at about 139,000 BOE per day. So it's a substantial amount of our operation now. We also see it as being probably our best options for long-term growth, as there's a lot of disjointed assets owned by a lot of different operators, a lot of assets that are not considered to be core to a lot of bigger companies, that, you know, serves as a pretty good opportunity set for us to acquire at pretty reasonable multiples and valuations. And so we're really, really enthused about what we're seeing there. We think that's a big opportunity for us as we move forward to grow the company, to scale up that central region further.
All right. And can you explain this pre-tax loss kind of as a result of the non-cash impairment caused by your hedging positions that you explained before? Can you kind of take us through this?
Oh, yeah. So essentially, you know, we've always, as a company, have told our investors, we're not going to take price risk. And so we're always hedging a couple of years in advance of the years in which we're sitting in today. So a lot of the hedges that we're recognizing right now, the cash aspect of it, were put on a couple of years ago or 12 months ago or whatever. And so those losses really are a result of those, the net loss of those hedges as we sit here today. Obviously, prices have went up substantially in the last 6 months, 7 months. And so we're seeing a mark to market on that hedge portfolio, especially in those ABS transactions, which have long-term hedging in them, representing a pretty large mark to market. We're okay with that. We still are going to see 50% margins. We're still protecting the downside for our investors and making sure that our dividend is protected on for a long term and long term period. If you go back and look at 2020, those same hedges that we have on today, you know, we recognized $140 million worth of gains. So some years it gives, some years it takes back. But at the end of the day, we're locking in our cash, the cash returns that we need to operate the business and pay the dividends.
All right. And that's ultimately the most important thing, right, for investors.
For us, that's what it's all about.
Yeah. I want to talk about ESG because that's equally as important in this day and age. And you've kind of set out your initiatives and your commitments in 2021. I know that you're trying to be kind of ahead of the curve in relation to your peers, and that's also important. How do you see this progressing over the next 12 months or so?
Well, we've already hit the ground running. We're not only hoping to be ahead of our peers, we are ahead of our peers. And so we've deployed our handheld emissions devices. We've started to roll those out through the operation. We've got, you know, some initial results from that, which we'll talk about in our earnings call. You know, we've seen a substantial reduction in our reported 2020 emissions. We went back and restated those, and then 2021 we've seen a further reduction. We're doing our flyovers like we said we would with our LIDAR flyover emissions detection, fixing leaks that we see there, and then changing out pneumatic devices. We're doing all the things that we said we would do back at our Capital Markets Day in November, and we're ahead of the game, and we're going to see substantial reductions as we move forward. And we're already seeing those as reported this morning.
All right, Rusty, thank you very much indeed. What else do you want to say to investors today in a nutshell?
At the end of the day, you know, we've been now public for 5 years. What we said we would do as a company, we continue to do it. We do it very consistently. We do it at a high level. And it's still, as we move forward, we'll see the same type of results as we move forward.
All right, sounds good. Rusty Hutson, thank you very much indeed from Diversified Energy this morning here on Proactive.
Thanks, Katie.